are talking to one of the greatest trainers in the history of boxing, Joe Goosen. He's made many, many champions over the years. But one thing I was very impressed, yeah. Joe, you did an interview with Mark Kriegel of ESPN. And you, to the T, described how Ryan Garcia was going to beat Luke Campbell. Quote, he's going to hit Luke Campbell with the left to the liver. How did you know that, Joe?
How do you know Mike Tyson's going to hit you with a bomb? I mean, you know, if you know, I know Ryan pretty well. And he trained at my gym for, you know, a number of months. And I know Ryan pretty well, and I know what his best attributes are, I think. And I just, you know, I know that everyone loves his left hook, and it's true, and they love his speed, which is true. It's all, you know, he's got so many great qualities. But the thing that always stood out to me most was that left hook to the body that he had. You know, you can call it the liver shot, body shot, whatever you want to call it. But that left hook to the liver is a game changer. And, you know, some guys, and I think a lot of fighters would say, you know, they'd rather get hit on the chops than get hit with a good liver shot.
Why? What happens to you when you get hit clean on the liver?
It paralyzes you.
How does that work?
That's all.
How does that work physically?
Well, your liver, you know, sits right underneath your rib cage here, but it kind of runs all the way across here. It's a big organ. And if you get hit on it, and it hides behind, you know, the safety net of your rib cage, just like your heart and your lungs. And so if you're able to, you know, put your glove on the right spot there.
On the button.
It's kind of indescribable unless you get hit with one. But it's paralyzing, it's debilitating. You can be in the greatest shape in the world and want to get up, but somehow your body just won't react to your command. It's one of those things. It's just, like I say, a lot of guys would rather get hit on the chin than get hit with a great liver shot.
Now, I've known you for many years. I've known Ryan for many years. I actually met him at your gym. You've always been a big believer in Ryan,
yeah.
And you've always said to this day that Ryan Garcia will never lose. Why do you say that, Joe?
Well, look, talent, you know, you got a lot of talented guys in this game, and you always will. And guys that maybe aren't blessed with the greatest talent in the world, but they work so hard, and they apply themselves so well that they're able to overcome the shortcomings of not being athletic in a way, or gifted, you know, talent-wise, but they make up for it with grit and determination and hard work. Well, Ryan's got all of those qualities, plus he's a very gifted athlete. He's, you know, I mean, doesn't take, you know, you get a guy in your gym and you see what they do at a young age when you're just 17 to a lot of the pros and stuff, and you go, well, this is a special kid. And that's just the easiest way for me to explain it. He's special. There are guys that are special in this game. We know who they are. Mayweather's, Pacquiao, and, you know, I could give you, it's a laundry list of them.
And Ryan's one of them.
He's just that good. And, you know, guys like Ryan, they can go a long way in this game without getting beat. You know, Mayweather, he's had fights that have been more competitive than others, but he's just that special guy. And I think Ryan's got that type of quality, you know, where, you know, he's heavy-handed for a guy that looks thin, but he's very heavy-handed. And I don't know, I'm probably leaving a lot of great names off the list about guys who are superior athletes. They just have something about them, like Roy Jones did, you know. Even Tyson looked like a cut above everyone else. He was hot. De La Hoya, you know.
What does it mean, Joe, when Ryan gets dropped, but he gets up, legs are there, chin is there, he fights back, and he wins by knockout? How much heart did it show?
Well, listen, I mean, it's not unexpected for a fighter to get dropped at some point in his career. you just never know when it's going to be. This was Ryan's time to get dropped by a very capable fighter with the distance with Lomachenko and Linares. Never been stopped before. And I'm sure Luke Campbell was in superior shape for this fight. He reacted the way, if you're in the corner and you're looking at your fighter go down, he reacted in a way that would give you some confidence in the corner about what was to come. So he got up strong. You know, he went down hard, but he got up strong, and he fought back. And again, came back to almost make Campbell look like he was ready to give up the ghost at the end of the fifth round, was it?
True, yep. He turned around, picked up his hands.
And... Well, he got hit with a really good left hook that round. And then a flurry of punches by Ryan then followed. And I think the bell was... Did Campbell a big favor because he got out of that trap, but a couple rounds later, he eventually got stopped by that liver shot. So Ryan did, you know, he reacted the right way. You know, he reacted the right way. He's very determined. Anything can happen when you get two guys at that stage of the game, okay? I don't care who you are. You know, when you get two guys that are really, really good, you know, the guy that you think should win doesn't always win, you know? But, so Luke Campbell tried to, you know, I think he did his best. I think he trained very hard. He's a very difficult guy.
Gold medalist.
Tricky southpaw, gold medalist. You know, very qualified guy. And he's big, too. He's 5'9 himself, you know? So I think that's a huge, huge win for Ryan. I'm sure it's going to give him a ton of confidence.
Speaking of which, the WBC president, Mauricio Sulaiman, just did an interview with SiriusXM where he said, we're going to let Ryan celebrate, but then we're going to mandate Ryan Garcia, Devin Haney. You've seen Devin Haney in here spar one of your guys. You know Devin. You know Ryan. Yeah. How do you see that fight unfolding? And what do you think of Ryan and Tank?
Well, there's another great example of three guys you mentioned that anything can happen. Tank looks unbeatable. Devin Haney looks really, really good. Ryan Garcia, to me, is a star. He's going to be difficult, if not impossible, to beat. And he's going to, believe me, each fight these guys have, they take away a lot more information. Where, you know, you can learn in 7-8 rounds in a fight more than you can 7-8 weeks in the gym or 7 or 8 months, to tell you the truth. So it's a learning experience. They're all, you know, involved in a big learning curve right now, and they're going to get better and better. And by the time they meet, you're going to go, well, it's kind of a pick'em fight. It's like, who do you pick? You're going to have fans on one side and fans on the other. I'm a fan of all these guys. They're all the next generation of champions that could and should be around for many, many decades, or at least years, you know?
And Joe, what do you think of Eddie Reynoso? He coached Canelo from zero to pound-for-pound king, 5 fights, 5 knockouts with Ryan. He has success with Frank Sanchez. You know Frank, of course.
Right.
Nery won a title with him recently.
The proof's in the pudding, you know? If you're getting results, people are going to take notice. And Eddie's doing a great job. He's doing a great job. He's a hard worker. And that's what it takes. You got to be in the gym. And he's making his mark right now. But the true test will be when these guys, you know, like a Frank Sanchez you were talking about, and a Neary, and they get a little bit more road to cover. Done a great job with Ryan, Canelo, of course, and Sanchez looked much more improved in his last fight. I think he settled him down. And then Neary, I've always liked Neary. I just don't see him often enough.
But yeah. The discipline with other coaches, when he was training another coach, he didn't have that discipline. Now he's disciplined. That's the difference.
Okay. All right. So, well, that's good to hear.
Yeah.
I think
he made weight easy where before he really struggled.
Yeah, I think Neri's just like, he's a monster, man. That guy's so good.
From TJ, right?
Pardon?
Tijuana.
Yeah, yeah. And really had very, almost no amateur fights.
Wow.
I mean, very few. I mean, I think maybe like 20. You know?
Impressive.
That's almost unheard of.
It's true.
I don't want to say unheard of, but it's rare in today's market because most of these guys come out of the amateurs with minimum 50 fights, 100 fights, you know.
So to end this interview, what did Mark Kriegel tell you after the fight? Because Mark Kriegel is considered the number one of the greatest boxing reporters. Did he call you and say, Joe, how the heck did you know he's going to win? Did he ask you?
I talked to Mark today.
Uh-huh.
And he just said you called it, that's all.
The only one to call it.
Pardon?
You're the only one to call it.
Well, probably not, but if you say so.
You called the punch. Ryan told me before the fight that Luke is open for that body shot, and the body shot will drop it.
Oh, he did? Though.
Yes.
Okay.
But you called it as well. So.
Well, look, I mean, again, you know, if you put a bat in a kid's hands, as a 12-year-old, and they start putting them over the fence, you go, okay, well, this guy's good. So anyway, he put the gloves on Ryan when he was just a kid, and he was just, like, hurting a lot of grown men in here with that body shot. You come to appreciate what you see very, very quickly. And it wasn't really brain surgery, to tell you the truth. It's just familiarity with Ryan, and he landed a great shot. And it was a tricky shot, too, because Campbell, you know, was expecting the hook to the head a lot, and then Ryan stepped in what looked to be a hook to the head coming, but he switched up right as he delivered it and just dropped it into the body. And it was a great shot because Campbell's hands were up high, and he gave him that big opening there. And that's hard to recover from, Ellie.
That's true. So there you have it. Joe Goosen, always been a big supporter of Ryan Garcia, called it which punch would end the fight, and he was right. FaceNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. You can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach. Thank you, Joe. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FaceNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.